64 was really enormous fun and an eye-opener how people prepare themselves for the Olympics. Well, we did well in practice, and we found ourselves really up with and beating the Italians. Two teams from each country. The two Italians were 9 times and 11 times world champions, but never won an Olympic medal, so they were really up for it. So they came really very powerful, and we were beating them in practice. And when the race came, well, there was sort of minor panic with the team. We had belts, we had spares of everything, but they were down at the bottom of the run, and we weren't sure whether we could get down there and get back up again with a spare belt in time for our next run. So we were prepared to withdraw the number two sled to take the axle bolt off that. When Monty heard, Eugenio Monty, the Italian, heard what was going on, and said, well, if you get a chap down to the bottom after my second run, which is at the beginning of the second run, he can rush back with that and he will be able to get it back up in time for your run. And so this was what happened. In actual fact, we got a bolt from somewhere else, and I don't know where they got the bolt from, but the gesture was fantastic, and we had a chap down there, and before he spoke to any of the press, he whipped out a spanner and took the bolt out of his sled and handed it to the Englishman waiting down there, and who went up to the top of the track with it. He got the Coubertin medal for sportsmanship in 1964, which was absolutely right. And he was a lovely fellow and a great mate of mine. In fact, all the Italians were great friends of ours.